Out of body. It is easy to get bout of body experience. You are already unwittingly performing out of body encounters or astral traveling while you sleep. Welcome to the Paranormal Life channel. I hope you like viewing this clip. Remember click like. I'm sharing my own out of body experience with you and make brief suggestions on how to perform out of body experience. You must attempt which method is best suited to you. In a nutshell, an out-of-body experience is basically your mind or awareness. You should first of all start getting out-of-body experience when you sleep. It is called lucid dreaming, meaning, getting aware you are dreaming. Practice makes perfect. What a wondrous world awaits the out-of-body traveler, where nothing is impossible. However, you will have to realize astral traveling is all about your mind. Your mind switches from the physical body to the astral counterpart when you slip out of your physical body and into the higher realms. Your soul leaves your body through your breath and mainly through your solar plexus chakra, energy center, because your soul is connected to your breath. Your soul cannot get lost once outside your body. It is firmly connected to the astral cord, which can stretch endlessly even to the edge of the universe. Wherever your mind can go, there you as your soul can go. The astral cord is silvery in color. There are numerous books in print about how to perform astral projection and astral traveling. In this book, I'm taking you on a fascinating journey of discovery as well as some exploration of my own personal astral encounters. Astral traveling has nothing to do with your belief system, religion, or politics. It is as natural to you as breathing in and out. In fact, your astral self is a direct and exact duplicate of yourself. But it's not the real you. Your physical body as well as your astral body are part of your real self, which is known as your higher self. You are not alone. Did you know you are not alone on your soul journey on Earth in this physical realm? Actually, you have agreed upon a soul contract and you have arranged guidance along the way on your soul journey. For each one on a soul journey is assigned a guardian. Most call it guardian angel. You also have a demonic being assigned to you who will mislead you. You have spirit guides as well as a main spirit guide. These guides assist you when you astral project. And, you have an astral lover or many astral lovers. Astral lovers are not assigned to you, but they are attracted to you. There are countless cases of people reporting seeing a ghostly lover. What is astral projection and astral travel? You are actually performing astral projection and astral traveling each time you go to sleep. The difference is, you were not aware you were outside your body, because you forget most of what transpired. What you do remember is recollected as a dream. In your dream, you perceive your interaction in a daze or unclear perception. At this juncture, I'd like to point out, recollection upon awakening of what transpired in your dream is based on your mental and spiritual ability. I've seen while I was outside my body, highly evolved spiritual people after soul ejection, tend to wander far and wide, whilst lower developed people, spiritually speaking, tend to remain or hover very near their physical bodies. Incidentally, when I speak of spiritual, according to my own understanding, I do not imply a mystical or religious phenomenon, but I mention the term spiritual to denote a different realm, an otherworldly realm. There are countless books describing what astral projection and astral travel is, but I'm relating my empirical encounters regarding the occurrence. First of all, you should understand the composition of your being as a living entity. You are not only a physical body, but you are an energy, known as a soul, which is vested inside your physical body. You are alive and living inside a physical body. This physical body's awareness is through its conscious mind. The conscious mind is limited and it is this conscious awareness which aligns with the physical environment. There are also unlimited books written through the ages on the soul and the body. According to my perspective, this physical body is not really who you are. It is a mere vehicle of your more real persona. You are not the body. The body is merely your garment, or name it what you will. In fact, your etheric self or your doppelganger cannot remain in your physical body throughout your mortal life. It does not belong to this dense physical realm and it ejects itself every night when you are asleep, to replenish itself. Your etheric self, which is a lower form of your soul self, is in essence driven by the subconsciousness. While the physical self is bound by the conscious mind, it is limited, what we call being realistic. This limited reality of what is real and what is not really real to your limitless soul self. Your conscious mind is your real enemy, because it entraps you into a limited void of what is conceptualized as being real. In the world of the physical, you as a physical body with its five senses are adapted, but not you as your soul self. When I first came to London a while back, I was somewhat petrified at the big city. I booked in at a backpackers in Bayswater and strolled to Waverley Center, almost directly down the road, to do some groceries shopping. That was about 3 p.m. When I got outside Waverley Center, I could not find myself back at the backpackers I had booked in. I had the keys in my pocket, but I didn't memorize the address. I got lost, because all the buildings appeared the same. At 12 a.m. I was still lost. I even asked several people to tell me where I lived, at which backpackers. Most laughed, thinking I was funny. I looked for a deserted spot and meditated, allowing my soul to slip out of my body. My soul self located the venue immediately. Whenever I found myself outside my body, I'd always encounter the dead people who went about their own usual business. Whether you intend to perform soul projection or astral projection, it will indeed take place, with or without your knowledge. The difference is, you will have to train or instruct your mind self to consciously project. Ejecting your soul self while asleep would be your first stage of astral projection. Hence, the basics of astral projection is based on a subconscious mind feat and not a conscious mind endeavor. A realm of wonder. The astral realm is not somewhere out there in the far distant dimensions. It is right here. Everything is right here. All the realms, all the worlds, all the dimensions and all the infinite universes, outside our own universe, these are all right here. Even the seven firmaments are right here. And, heaven is right here. Everything is at one point. Even the past, present and future and beyond that, is right here. The astral realm is the exact replica of our earthly domain. Whatever you find on Earth has an exact carbon copy replica. I found when I was outside my body that I wore the exact same clothes as was on my physical body. But what I found most amazing was that I was in control. It was my mind that was powerful. I saw there were images following each and every person. These images were their thought patterns they have created through their earthly aspirations. If you were a lustful person, the image of your ideal sexual object would follow you. You have given it life. I found there were many phantom beings in the astral world, some ugly, some pretty and most just misty. Rich people dream of more money. The image of money and its splendor follow them. Farmers dream of crops and this image follows them. The impoverished dream of a house, money, and food which also follow them. In the astral realm you can visualize something into effect. You want a beautiful house with a lake at the back. Plus, you want a nice rowing boat on the lake with a pretty damsel inside. Guess what? Your mind can indeed materialize about anything. There are different beings in the astral realm. The astral realm comprises of three main dimensions, lower, middle, and higher astral worlds. Osborne Phillips says in his book, The Astral World or Plane, that at its lower levels it is so close to the physical universe that a dividing line cannot easily be maintained. It includes our astral bodies, the soul stuff of the individual psyche. Etheric sight in ordinary consciousness. The lower levels of the astral world are sometimes termed etheric. Many people, without leaving their physical body at all, can make use of etheric sight,